Don't receive we don't receive money. We receive something kinds tokens. Yeah. Just tokens.
Okay.
And but you cannot receive gifts from somebody transacting business with the armed forces.
Ah, okay. Yes. But as controller, does he deal with suppliers?
He deals with dealers.
So siguro sa palagay niyo doon nang galing yung mga suppliers dealer ganon ganon ba
possible.
It's up for General Garcia to explain his wealth.
Well, kaya General Cruz, personally, what do you feel about General Garcia and his wealth, alleged wealth?
I feel sorry for him.
Why?
Well, if he has to come clean right now. But it's in the court right now.
Okay. What class is
he's under litigation.
What class is he, by the way, General Garcia? A or ba siya? He's an A.
Yes.
What class? Are any of you his mista?
No.
upper class kayo.
Ang training namin kasi PIAW, sometimes we are gentle. We are gentle guys. Mm-hmm. And we cannot accuse somebody unless proven is guilty. Mm-hmm. Ganito kami katimid, not because that we do not want to be engaged in General Garcia. I think it's unfair for anybody.
Have any of the four of you ever tried to challenge him? Diba merong challenge among PM Aries, yung all right, sir.
All right, sir.
Yeah.
did you ask him, sir? Did you ask him na?
I did not.
Kayo, sir. Sir, kanina pa kayo tahimik eh. Hindi. Sir, kayo, did you ask him? Did you challenge General Garcia? All right, sir.
Well, hindi kami nagkaroon ng chance sa magkita.
Okay. Kayo po, General Cruz?
No.
Never. Have you heard of anyone who has challenged him in that way?
Challenge is only in the academy.
Sir, minsan, even after life in the academy, may mga ganon.
Of course. May ganon talaga.
Well, since talking about General Garcia makes you very uncomfortable, the four of you, let's talk about Rear Admiral Angge. Very briefly lang po, mga 30 seconds. What's the status of his case?
May pre-trial investigations in the case of General Angge. The Philippine Navy, after the investigations, there is a recommendation for him to face court-martial. Mm-hmm. As the chief of staff, I ordered the deputy chief of staff or as the assistant of General Cruz to have the pre-trial investigations. And after 2 weeks, I think he can have his recommendations whether he face the court-martial or not.
Yeah. One of his major complaints is that favoritism daw, politicking. May ganun pa ba?
That's why we don't have this favoritism. That's why he'll be undergoing this pre-trial investigation, because what is the law governing the privates should be the law, should be the rules that will be govern the real admiral.
Okay. Right now you have the DND, is it the DND or the AFP that's going to be accepting all these amnesty applications from these rebel officers?
It is the
DND.
It's the Department of Defense.
Okay. So hindi na po ang AFP mag-handle nun?
We have our TJAG, the Judge Advocate General, is part of the member of the committee.
There's an amnesty committee.
Jana David, you're retiring March 8th.
Yeah, March 8th.
2011. Yeah. So you would have been in office
for 8 months.
8 months.
Yes.
How does the AFP feel about this, so-called revolving door policy and how it can be solved? There was or is a pending bill in Congress na dapat 3 years ang term.
Yeah, I feel that the chief of staff should have a longer period of term in the armed forces. Tulad ko, and we have a plan. Hindi ko masasabi kung this will be successful or not. Mm-hmm. I'll just be leaving a plan to the armed forces, tong IPSP bayanihan.
Yeah.
So kung 3 years yan, he can have some projects that may grow or makikita niya kung accomplish, and then he can adjust.
Yeah.
He can adjust as siya kasi ang may vision or may plan on. But in this case, you just leave this plan behind. But of course, marami tayong magagaling sa Armed Forces of the Philippines. But in studies, sabi nga nitong sa personal management, at least 2 to 3 years ang dapat ang chief of staff. We hope that this will be fast passed by Congress that the chief of staff and the major services will have a term of 2 years.
Okay.
Siguro napakaganda nito sa armed forces.
You hope it will be passed before you step down?
No, it will be passed after na, yeah.
Ah, okay. Sir, I'm not pushing you out the door, something, yeah. No? Pero would you know kung sino yung mga possible na papalit sa inyo?
Yeah,
and I'm sure right now, may jockeying na kasi two months to go.
I think yun na mahirap, ayaw ng mga jockeying eh.
Mm-hmm.
The more na mag-jockey ka siguro, the more na hindi ka mapipili.
Okay.
So, among the three-star general in the armed forces,
mm-hmm.
who can be the next chief of staff. In fact, the commander-in-chief can choose from the colonel.
Mm-hmm, right.
From the colonel that's in the uh-huh. embodied in the...
Can you give us a few names or...
Well, we have, of course, the vice chief of staff, Okarabena, the CG Pop, the commanding general of the Philippine Army, Ortiz,
the usual candidates.
The TDCS, and the unified commander, Rolly de Tabali, Villanueva, and Deng Perev.
Mm-hmm.
These are the candidates to be the chief of staff. Well, okay. It's up to the president. Will be the
okay. We'll close this segment by closing with an issue that hounded you, the AFP, for the most part of 2010, and then it ended. 2010 ended with that. No? So we have that Morong 43 arrest in Feb, release itong December. General Peralta, how do you feel that with the way the AFP handled the issue?
Morong 43.
Yes.
I think we did it very professionally.
Mm-hmm.
There were instructions, there were procedures, and we abided by all of this.
Mm-hmm.
And that is how a professional approaches.
Yeah. So you're saying you are categorically denying that there was any of those torture, mga psychological torture, mga...
Ayun, hindi, wala pa na.
Ang sinasabi nilang torture, alam ba, sabi ko nga, during the program, hinangkap, is that torture?
Mm-hmm.
O kaya, some, siguro, noong araw, hindi pa nila nalalaman na yung peering ay torture. Pero itong sinasabi ko sa kanila, pinalo ba sila? Sinuntok ba sila? O yung torture na sinasabi, were there bodily abuse?
Yung mga ine-escort sa comfort room, halimbawa, yung mga ganun.
I think walang ganun.
Wala.
They were not tortured. Magaling yung commander doon, yung brigade commander doon sa pag-handle noon. Siyempre, yung ang lima, the five of them were left in the second infantry division. Ayaw nila sumama.
Bakit nga ba? It's because
they admitted they were underground. They admitted.
Mm-hmm.
And they're not willing to embrace the SIP, Social Integration Program.
Mm-hmm.
And they were not intimidated. They were not coerced. They wanted to surrender.
Mm-hmm. Of course, the other side claims otherwise.
Propaganda.
And itanong natin yung ano, kami handa kami naman magsalit, they will be interviewed in any forum. Yung mga lima na yun, kung talagang sila ba ay pinabayaan ng armed forces o sila ba ay talagang...
You know, when they had the best food there. They had the best food.
Where?
The best billeting. In the army camp where they were temporarily billeted.
Really?
Yes.
Oh, like what do you mean, sir? Like what kind? Anong ulam nila?
Better than, I think.
Better than yung ulam ng sundalo. Kung sasama loob ng sundalo doon. Anyway, okay. Our discussion will continue after the break. Our discussion with the generals, Rookie Politics, will be right back. Stay with us.